We decided to sell the ashram in Santa Barbara in order to consolidate finances and personnel, all our resources, and to make our East Coast Center our international headquarters. We had just purchased Yogaville, Virginia, and we were consolidating. So we closed everything down, and then we had to shut down our Connecticut ashram, which was the East Coast Center before Virginia, pack that up as well. So myself and a good friend, Bashkar, we were designated as the people to drive one of Gurudev's classic antique Cadillac convertibles from West Coast to the East Coast. Somehow we took the southern route, and it was record-breaking hot temperatures. When you'd open the door, it was literally like you were sticking your head in an oven. It was triple-digit weather every day. So as to be expected, the car began having problems. And Gurudev told us to call him every single day and to sleep during the day and to drive at night when the weather was cooler. Made good sense. And we followed that. And a couple of times we had to stop and have repairs for a couple of days. It was an interesting journey, but every day we spoke to him, and I remembered we'd get on the phone and he'd go, "Are you two still alive out there? Are you still there?" And it was so much fun. The car was bubblegum pink. Imagine a classic Cadillac convertible, bubblegum pink. So it definitely elicited notice as we made our trek cross country. And we even had on several occasions people in new, expensive, modern cars drive up next to us and offer to trade vehicles. It was, the car had that much energy to it. Well, at one point, we were on this deserted highway. We hadn't seen another car in many, many, many miles. The car decided to totally break down. Fortunately, there was an overpass a few hundred yards in front of us, and we were able to coax the car forward so at least we could have some shade. And we both proceeded to collapse in the car. We just collapsed. And we would have no doubt expired there totally had not, out of the blue, out of nowhere, this man drives up in a truck. We hadn't seen anyone. It might have been hours. This man drives up in a truck. He rouses us and wants to take us to his home. Bashkar won't leave the car because it's Gurudev's car. He said, "I'm not going to leave it. If you have a was called a winch or something to hook up and tow us, I'm not leaving." So he collapsed again on the seat. And rather than try to argue with him, this man, a complete stranger, picks me up, puts me in his car, drives off. We get to his home. It's either his wife or his daughter was there. They draw a tub, fill it with cold water, and clothes and all, they pick me up and they put me in the tub. Saved my life. He goes back immediately, hooks up the truck, brings Bashkar. I don't even think he got out of the car. I think he was just towed in the car. As soon as Bashkar arrived, they picked me up out of the tub. They didn't even change the water. They picked him up, clothes and all, and put him in the cold tub. And then they fed us. They provided us a place to sleep that night. They cared for us. I remember I tried to communicate with them afterwards, sending them thank you notes. Never got a response. To tell you the truth, I don't even know if they really existed. I don't want to get far out here, but Gurudev was clearly watching us every moment. We were on a mission dedicated to his service, and it was end time if there weren't some miraculous intervention. And there he was, this good Samaritan, perfect timing. Either it was incredible synchronicity, serendipity, or it was direct divine intervention. And I don't know if there's a difference between the two, actually. So that's how one of Gurudev's Cadillacs got back here to Virginia.